morning, beautiful people of God. This is Prophetess Rivers with another word, another message. Today I want to talk to everyone about the works that Jesus has done while he was on this earth. Yes, we know Jesus as our deliverer. We know him as our healer. We even know him as our redeemer and our salvation. We know him for his death, burial, and his resurrection. We even know him for the miracles that he's done, and we even know him for the casting out the demons that he did while he was here. But it's much more than that. It's much more to know about Jesus while he was here on this earth. While we look and we begin to know Jesus, even the more we begin to see the concerns and the desires that God has for his people and for this earth while Jesus was here. We begin to see that while Jesus was here, he first ministered to the Hebrews and to the Jews. He began to minister to them, and then he hit the streets, and then he began to minister to the Gentiles. We begin to see that while Jesus is doing these things, we see that Jesus is at his best. He is evangelizing to all those that are around him. He has started a movement that will soon turn into a lifestyle for those that are his. Those that are his, as me saying that, that are disciples of his. Those that are willing to do the Great Commission. Those that have a mandate on their life. And as us being God's children, we must understand as we begin to evangelize that we have authority. In fact, there is a transfer of authority from the Father to the Son to the children of his, because we are descendants of Abraham. We must understand that as us doing the will of God, that it is more than just being disciples. Yes, we know to be a disciple means to be Christ-like and to be followers of Christ, but it's much more than that. We are fully trained, we are fully taught, and we are fully tested to be more and more like Jesus every single day. Before Jesus left this earth, Jesus wanted everybody that was around him and all those that were his to know that he is their lordship. And I couldn't understand it fully. Yes, he is our Father, he is our King, but why is it that he wanted us to know that he was our lordship? Because if you know that he is the Lord over your life, and you know that he is your King, then you know how to operate and be effective in the kingdom of God. Remember, this is more than just a movement, but this is a lifestyle that Jesus has for us. Now, the question of the week is, what do you do when somebody comes to you and tells you, oh, this person said this or that about you? Well, now, remember, this person used to be cool with this person, but now that they're no longer talking to that person, they're going and they're telling that person something that you said about them. Well, that comes with wisdom as well, because I see it as, why are you telling me something that somebody else, let's just scratch that. First, you shouldn't even be gossiping to begin with. You shouldn't be a tale-bearer. So if somebody is coming to you telling you something that the next person said about you, you should look at that person's character right there, because why are they sitting up there telling you something that someone else said about you? And if that person was cool with that person, and now that they fell out with that person, and they're telling you something that he or she said about you, you need to sit back and you need to tell that person, well, why did it have to take for you to fall out with that person to tell me what they said about me? Whether they're your friend, whether they're your spouse, whether they're your family member, or maybe they're just another person average on the street. You're telling me what they said after they fell out with you? Don't tell me what they said about me unless you tell me what you said to defend me. Remember, I love you, God loves you, and all that you do, give God the honor, glory, and praise. To God be the glory.